Hi, my name is Dr. Jessica Seat, and I am with Boehringer Ingelheim. I'm the technical manager for enterics and oral vaccines, and I'm here today to present our first industry's commercial quantitative PCR for Lawsonia intracellularis, created and developed by BI's Health Management Center in Ames, Iowa. So we are extremely excited at BI to have developed the industry's first qPCR for Lawsonia. It's going to change how we approach the disease. Your traditional PCR is more qualitative, so it just lets you know that there's the presence or absence of Lawsonia. This now will quantify the concentration of bacteria present in the fecal material, so it can actually give us the severity of the disease in the pig at the time. Currently, right now, the qPCR is available for fecal samples only. It is available at the HMC in Ames, Iowa. We are adapting the test and hopefully we'll be able to use it for other sampling techniques such as oral fluids and environmental swabbing, but currently the test is only for fecal material. The qPCR that we've developed is like your regular PCR, except for it has more precise standards. It's the same methods that we're already familiar with, but we've just made it more precise. The qPCR is also, they've adjusted it for inhibition. And so inhibition is where it will interfere with the amplification of the nucleic acids, therefore giving a false interpretation of the test, possibly a false negative, false positive. So we've adjusted for that. So feed ingredients or other bacteria that may be present in the fecal material. What this qPCR will do is it will help us identify the subclinical and the clinical pigs. And the part we underestimate is that subclinical pig for Lawsonia. Now we'll be able to go in, test those pigs, and hopefully put an economic value on what we're losing in those pigs. In the literature, you'll find there's a correlation between the amount of bacteria shed in the feces to the severity of the disease. For instance, at a log of 10 to the 8th, we know that we'll have a clinical pig where we'll see lesions in the intestines, and also we may see the looseness and possibly even hemorrhagic stool. If we go to a log of 7, plus or minus clinical signs, a log of 6, that's where we start to see a subclinical pig. And so those pigs get missed. We don't recognize them because they're not having scouring, they're just not performing as well, but there's no clinical picture to identify. Then you go to a log of 5, and that's where the pig may be in the recovery stage. So again, they may look like your normal pig in the barn, but they actually are shedding a Lawsonia. Now the problem is that most people can't identify which pigs have Lawsonia because it's ubiquitous, so it's going to be throughout the entire barn. They'll all be exposed. It can be found worldwide. And so when you're comparing pigs to pigs in the barn, you're not comparing to what your normal healthy pig should look like. You're comparing it to a pig maybe that's more severe. So again, this qPCR opens up the opportunity now to kind of better immunity management, because we can do a monitoring program, we can identify a pattern or status of your herd, and identify a pinpoint time that maybe it would be the best time to go in with our enterasol ileitis vaccine and to vaccinate your herd. So as I mentioned, this qPCR is going to really help the industry, especially producers, because now, you know, before we would go in, we would do a diagnostic workup, have to do necropsies to identify lesions. Again, we were still missing those subclinical pigs, and we had a lot of questions and a lot of time spent. Now with the qPCR, we can go in addition to serology, again, we can get an answer and be able to correlate what we should be seeing in the pig. That will help the producer because we're doing less necropsies, which is beneficial. And also, it's a quick turnaround time to get an idea of what the status of your herd currently is. So as I mentioned, this is just the method is similar to the PCR that you're familiar with. We just made it more precise. In addition, as I mentioned, we adjusted for inhibition. So that combined, again, we've really made this test more accurate, more reliable, and definitely repeatable. So again, this just shows BI's leadership in enteric knowledge and vaccines.
This video is brought to you by Farms.com.